Hi, I'm Valentine, and I pounced on every joy like a ferocious animal, eager to strangle it. Archie Rumble.
You're dead and out of this world.
Today I'm doing something a bit unorthodox for my channel. I'm not going to be talking about books, but I'm going to be talking about something book adjacent still, which is majoring in literature at uni. Obviously, there are many subgenres to major in literature. I myself started my bachelor's in the Department of English Literature, and then after the first semester, I transferred into the Department of French Literature, where I am now going into my third and final year. But I feel like my observations could apply somewhat to most bachelor degrees with a focus on literature. But before we get into the meat and potatoes of it all, I need to give you a brief update on my personal academic life, because something happened and it's pretty nuts, and not the yummy yummy delicious kind. It's pretty bad, it's rotten. It was a very brutal change of plans, and I am under a lot of pressure right now because of it, and that is why I was absent from YouTube for like a much longer stretch of time than I would have preferred. So here are the bare bones of the situation. There's a lot of lore, it's a very convoluted and long story, but here's the basics of the basics. So remember I said I transferred from one department to another? The only reason I did that was I received an offer from the head of the French department to do my bachelor's in 2 years instead of one and go directly into a master's and have a scholarship for my master's. And I put up with incredible, staggering amounts of bullshit in this new department just to be able to do my master's faster and with a full financial support. But guess what? Recently, I started pushing the head of the department for answers about my master's because I was supposed to start it like in October and I still knew nothing about how this was going to work on like an administrative level and specifically on a financial level. And turns out the head of the department did not verify the conditions before promising me things. And the conditions are very different and there is no scholarship that I can get for my master's. So now I can't start my master's this year. I already found a supervisor. I already came up with a corpus for my research. I was very excited for it, and now I can't do it. The new plan is for me to finish my bachelor's here and apply to a master's in Europe in the meantime, in comparative literature instead of French literature, because that's what I wanted to build my career in anyway, and it makes sense to start early instead of waiting for my PhD. It's all for the best. If everything works out, this is going to be absolutely amazing for me. But it is a lot of unexpected stress and pressure because I basically have to figure out everything there is to figure out about moving to a different country, applying to a university in a different country, getting a scholarship in a different country, etc., 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 within a month. So now that you know why academics have been heavily on my mind, let's dive into my actual mad ramblings and musings. And obviously my experience is inevitably defined by what country I'm studying in, my specific university, my specific department, my specific professors. But something else that I feel like is very important to keep in mind while listening to my perspective is why I'm doing a degree in literature in the first place, right? I do want to be a researcher, I do want to stay in academia, that is certainly part of it, but another much bigger part of it is I just want to be a better artist. I want to be a better poet and a better writer. And controversial take, obviously it depends, it's very personal, but in my opinion, for me, it is more useful to get a degree in literature to work on my art than it is to get a degree in creative writing. Because the craft part of it I can work on by myself by just constant practice and experimentation and pushing my limits, but the historical awareness, the inspiration, the context, the broadening my horizons in terms of what is even possible side of it, it is much, much easier to acquire doing a degree in literature. and being constantly bathed in the works of recognized masters and asked to think very deeply and very carefully about what makes each of them so special and so impactful and how they're interconnected, that is very, very enriching and empowering. To kick things off, I was once asked by my friend what were the best and worst parts of getting this degree. And the best part for sure is that I feel like I've been preparing for getting this degree my entire life, because I always had a very genuine interest in books and various arts and history. So now it just feels very natural to be continuously learning about all these things very intensely. And I also have a lot of cultural baggage that I bring with me already at the start of the degree, and that makes things run much smoother and easier. The worst thing is very subjective and personal, but I feel like nobody talks about it ever, and I cannot imagine I'm the only person who would be negatively impacted by it. I have a lot of mental health issues, and I have a lot of trigger warnings I have to be on the lookout for, and I should be carefully avoiding. But when you're majoring in literature, it is virtually impossible to avoid reading very, very upsetting texts. Obviously, you don't have full control. You have very little control, in fact, over the texts you are required to read. They're mandatory reading, and it can be extremely tricky to navigate. And in my opinion, it is a problem specific to art degrees or like literature degrees, because there's a big difference, in my opinion, between learning about something upsetting in an objective scientific way that is very detached and having to immerse yourself into a work of art that is designed to make you feel these things. And if I'm ever in any position of power in academia, I will do my best to try and draw attention to this issue and come up with some ways to mitigate this problem and make it easier for both students and professors to navigate. But for now, I'm just sort of stuck dealing with it, and it's unfortunate. Now let's dive into more general, less emotionally charged points. Here's the thing I wish I was more prepared for, because I certainly had very incorrect expectations, is because literature is a very impractical degree, it doesn't have a lot of promising career outcomes. I was convinced that most, if not all, people who apply for a degree in literature are doing this out of passion. They're just very invested into the subject, they can't help but choose to study it, which is my case. But that is not true. That is very far from the truth. Just as with any degree with a relatively low barrier of entry, so like not law school, not med school, you know, there will be a lot of people who are just here to get any degree, just any diploma at all, because it's hard to apply for jobs without a bachelor's in this economy. And it's fine, it's valid. There are people who are here kind of by accident because they panicked and didn't know what college or like major to apply to because they're fresh out of high school. Makes sense. It's just, it was a little disheartening for me because I was so excited to be around people who are as insane about the subject as I am, and in a lot of cases most people are like, this is boring, I hate that, who would possibly want to read this boring crap? And I'm like, I would. But I was fortunate enough to find a friend who is as unhinged as I am, and that is one of the greatest joys of my life, so don't lose hope. Secondly, I did mention you will be required to read books that you find very upsetting. But even more frequently, you will be asked to read books that you don't like and you find boring, frankly. Which is different from finding the whole degree boring. And like, I, for example, I love having like a bird's view of the entire history of literature. I love learning things. But reading very specific books may be a hassle because they're written in a way that just does not appeal to you. The philosophy, the art philosophy behind them is not what speaks to you the most. It's just a little bit of a drag. There is no single human, I refuse to believe there's a single human who's invested into every literary movement that ever existed. That's just not possible because they're so opposed and so antithetical to each other. So if you have a favorite, you have the least favorite, you know what I mean? Something that allows me to get through this more easily is I just remind myself that the things I love the most, the things I'm obsessed with the most, were not created in the vacuum, and in a very distant, very vague way, they are a response to literally everything that came before them. And I want to expand on something a little bit. At the beginning, I said that I feel like I've been preparing for this degree my entire life, but even now, whenever I watch a random documentary about some random country's history, or I read something for pleasure, or I listen to a podcast about culture, none of it is ever relevant and useless. All of it can be applied to my current degree and a very specific, very narrow period in a very specific, well-defined region. Everything in the world of art is wildly interconnected, and it is a permanent dialogue between everything that has ever been created. And I believe that art does not imitate life as much as art imitates art, or art responds to art, or reimagines art, or retells art, or opposes art. I am very salty. A bachelor's in comparative literature is not widely available, it's not very common, and it somewhat makes sense if you're studying East Asian literature, for example, or Latin American literature. But if you major in literally any of the European literatures, like English literature, French literature, Italian literature, you name it, most movements are pan-European. So even if I did, say, specialize in specifically English literature, and I only ever wanted to study English literature on all levels of my education, just nothing else, I feel like I would be less competent than necessary if I didn't know anything about the rest of Europe. It boggles my mind that I have to either Frankenstein my degree by trying to get a lot of credits from other departments, or self-study, which is more realistic, just to get the level of understanding and knowledge and context that I believe I require to be a good specialist in this area. Lastly, I just want everyone to be more aware that in humanities, even more so than in any other degree, your knowledge, the knowledge you receive, very much depends on your professors. And I'm not even talking about the quality of education here, which is another story entirely. I'm talking about the selection of books you read in a very basic way, or like the context you're given, the historical context you're given. Professors are very often free to select their own corpus, even in like introductory courses where they're supposed to give you a very general view that does encompass most things that are important, because what is important is very subjective, even when it comes to academic research. I had a professor who was very clearly alt-right, if we're being brutally honest, in terms of her political convictions. And once we started studying the 20th and specifically 21st century, oh my god, it was very obvious in her selection where she was leaning politics-wise and just worldview-wise. But even in less egregious cases, they can't give you a perfect, absolutely perfect, complete view of literally everything produced within a certain time period, or on a certain theme, or within a certain movement. You don't have the time for it within the confines of a semester, or even two semesters if it's like an annual course. So if you're only reading the things that are mandatory, and you're not doing any additional research at all on the side, you're not reading anything at all just for yourself, not for the grade, it's kind of sort of not enough. I mean, it depends on your goals entirely. Like, if you're just here to get a diploma, you're good, obviously. But if you want to be like a serious, competent academic in the area, not enough, not enough at all. Also, now that depends very much on how good your university is and how competent your professors are. But even if you trust your university to be super good, and you respect your professors, they can and do get things wrong, like a lot. They can make very glaring factual mistakes, which is not a good sign in terms of the quality of your education, but I had to deal with it a lot in my department.
I'm so tired. But often your professors specialize in a very specific, very narrow thing. One writer sometimes, or like one very, very, very short period of time. And they do know about other things, obviously, and they are familiar enough with them to teach them, but they may lack complete, full understanding of them. They may lack very, very detailed knowledge. They may omit certain things. They may not remember certain things. They may not find certain things important. And here is where it is important to do research outside of what you're taught in your lectures. It's never useless. It's never irrelevant. Everything is relevant. We discussed this. So it does pay off in major ways for you to be more independent in your studies. One last tiny reminder before we part ways. I do have a Ko-fi where you can support me financially. You can give me a tip if you so wish, if you so please. If you're feeling extremely unbelievably generous, which is how I always phrase it because that's how I feel about it. As I established at the beginning of the video, there are a lot of very sudden changes in my life, which entails a lot of unexpected expenses. So if you're in a place where you can comfortably help me out and you feel like it, I would be very, very grateful from the bottom of my heart. And without an awkward outro, bye-bye!